What's up, friends? AM Icebreaker for February 20th. It's a Tuesday, and man, I am no good at placing my camera ever. There we go. There, we're a little straight. Yeah. And let's see. Morning after the dry fast. I don't want to keep talking about it. Still feeling fine. Probably gonna go work out today. Definitely gonna get back to hydrating though. Hydrating regularly. Still gonna stay on liquid for a bit. So that's fine. And was reading an article this morning, because this has been a really interesting mental exercise, as you can probably imagine. And I was reading an article this morning that I saw on Facebook from Dr. Andy Galpin. Hopefully you guys know him. If nothing else, you've seen him on the JRE or the Onnit podcast, and I'll link both of those in the description. But basically the gist of the study was, there's a big meta-analysis and some review done that basically said, hey, do cardio and resistance training as, I think the quote was, as many times a week as is feasible to improve your cognitive function. And I think for a lot of us, that's kind of a given, right? Like, we get that. We get that, like, when we work out, we think better, we feel better. And I gotta say, I'm kind of glad this is, you know, there's been this idea, maybe some of you guys kind of get what I'm gonna say here, but you know, there's this quote, and it's attributed, I think, to Thomas Jefferson, but I don't know, I saw it on internet, so who knows how true it is, right? That is basically something to the effect of, you know, the sole purpose of the body is to cart the brain around. You know, like, the body is just this dead, meaningless thing, and all the what's really important is our thoughts and our feelings and all that stuff. But I mean, you know, if you follow Rhonda Patrick too, for example, you've probably heard a lot of her talk. I think she was on the JRE a little while ago, and she said something to the effect of, the blood-brain barrier is much more permeable than we thought. So basically what that means is more things come from our body, come from our bloodstream, come from our environment, the things we take in, and actually get to our brain. So, you know, to me, and I'm not a scientist, I'm not, you know, I'm a bro scientist, if nothing else. But to me, that basically says, hey, you know, there is that real, actual connection between the mind and the body. I mean, you know, and, you know, I mean, what Arnold's been preaching that his whole life, right? Put your mind in your muscles. But, so, you know, and I'm not going to turn this into a discussion about how exercise and nutrition is this cure-all, you know, for whatever is ailing you. I mean, I'm not going to, you know, some people need their drugs, some people, whatever. But it just speaks to this idea that the more we're starting to learn about this, the more we are realizing that, you know, we're one unit. You know, some, what do some people say, the embodied mind, I guess. But ultimately, I mean, what am I trying to say? I guess I'm just trying to say, go exercise, go move around. I mean, I'm not going to tell you what to do. I'm not going to be one of these, like, you know, zealots who's like, now you have to swing a kettlebell, you have to go play outside. I used to, you know, I mean, some of you guys know I used to pound some of those drums, but man, at this point, just go do something. Yeah, it's good for your brain, apparently. So that's what I got. Cheers.